Okay, now it's time to turn down one of the ends for bearings. I'm gonna do the Y-axis first. This is a normal Y-axis length. This is the one I'm gonna be working on. It's actually for X2 Freak conversion. A lot more wire travel. Sleeve. Need to make a hole in my cover. Oh, one way around. Oh, I see. It's got a removable cover. I'll take care of that. All right, cover removed. Now I can go all the way through. Now I need to turn down about 2.3 inches worth of thread. But to cut down on the noise, I'm only going to do about half of it right now. It's only going to stick out a little bit more than an inch beyond the sleeve. I'll turn, let's see, the final diameter on the Y, it's got to be 0.375. I'll turn this down to about 425. And then I'll move it out and finish the rest of the rough cutting. Just got to face it off and start turning. Like I said, I'm turning it 560 RPM. I'll take about 20-25 thousandths per pass. It'll make some noise, believe me, but it's hard stuff. Looks like I bumped something loose. Sleeve is about 3 inches long, so it holds on to plenty of the ball screw. And you can see the end bending out the back of the machine, turning pretty nice and true. So should work. Start facing it off. Faced off, and I'll start turning. Remember, about 20-25 thousandths a pass. I got that feed rate a little high. I'm going to slow it down.
About 6,000.
Remember,
where you're just gonna get that hard stuff off there. If it makes noise, it makes noise.
Got that part roughed out. Stick out just enough as I need. I need 200-300. So I make sure I got maybe about 1/8 inch more. Be on the chuck and tighten her back down. Now I can face off the end. At least we had a digital readout though. See, move that out. Still turning nice and true. Full sleeve works.